So Professor Liu is going to show you the solo learn from chapter 7. Let's start from the while loop. So loop, a loop repeatedly asks you a set of statements until a particular condition is satisfied. We first talk about is while loop. A while loop repeatedly ask you a target statement as long as a given condition remains true. So while whatever condition the statement, the loop iterates, so repeat, while the condition is true. At a point when the point becomes false, the program control shifts to the line that immediately follows the loop. All right, which is the right syntax of the while loop? So when you do while loop, you need to do a condition like this inside parentheses. So while backend less equal 5, cout text. Okay. So let's take a look at the while loop. There's a certain way you must do a while loop. The loop's body in the body of the statement within curly braces. For example, so here we have some initialization value. So outside the while loop, so in number equal 1, then you can check. If you don't have this, you cannot check. So while number is less than 6, and I'm going to display the numbers and num equal num plus 1. So that's what initial value and this update. When you are doing while loop and dealing with a number, you must do this. So this example above declare the variable equal to 1. The while loop check is that less than 6 and ask you the statement into its body, which increment and each one the loop run. After the 5th iteration number becomes 6, the condition evaluated to be false, the loop stop running. So this program will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, so next, fill out the blank. X equal 1. We are trying to do while loop. So type while. And here, so initialization update. Initialization update. Alright, so the while loop. The increment value can be changed. If change the number of the times, the loop is running will change. So this will be increment by 3. So first time is 1. Can you tell me what's the next number? Anybody? 4. Is that right? So 4 still so. For this program, how many number will be displayed? Charlton?
4.
Yeah. For this, the CL will be how many? Just 2 number, 1 and 4. Is that right? Let's see. So we see this one here, and we run them. Just 1 and 4. Okay. So if I change this to 2, if I change this to 2, and I run them, how many number will show?
1 and 3.
1, oh. 3, and 5. Is that right? You understand? Okay, everybody? So far, okay? All right. this car. Okay. So, we understand this right now. Let's continue. While loop. Fill in the blank to increment by 2 now. So, while initialization 0, when its condition is still less than 20, every time I'm going to increment by 2. So next one is 2, and 4, and 5, until 20. So this will loop 10 times. Alright, let's continue. Alright, so We have this right now, and we are going to do this using a while loop. So when do you do while loop? Using first, we're going to increment, decrement. The increment or decrement operator can be used to change value in the loop. So if this is 1, all right, and I'm going to compare a larger number, I probably will be plus plus. Num plus plus is equivalent to num equal num plus 1. All right, so using increment, decrement, same thing. You put while here and plus plus. Did you do that? All right. A loop can be used to obtain multiple input from a user. Let's create a program that allows user to enter a number 5 times. Each time store the input in a variable. Alright, so integer equal 1 and integer number. So I'm going to I'm going to ask for the user input 5 numbers and save into numbers 5 times. Alright, so this number actually will be replace the value. Alright, so right here, fill in the blank to allow user enter value using seeing and storing. So we do the same thing here. This is very similar to what I show you the example. Did you finish this? Okay. Alright, you'll modify your code to calculate the sum of the number the user has entered. So this is a little bit different. We're going to talk about accumulation. Alright, so when we accumulate, we do loop. Like I input 5 number. Then what's the total of this 5 number? A teacher enter student score. There are 40 students that enter score. What's the total? What's the average of the student score? Okay, that's a very important thing, important function. A teacher or an application need to know. So this is usually do like this. Initialization value, ending value, so 1 to 5. And the numbers. Alright, so the number you enter, we really don't want it to, you know, save it. Instead, we want to accumulate into total. So this means the number will be plus into a total. This line here is equal to total plus number. Alright, as I told you here, if you have both the equal sign on the left and right are the same variable, instead of doing that, we will not doing this. And what we do is we just add a plus sign in front. We add a plus sign in front. So this is ideally what we do, because we want to simplify. Instead of using 2 variables, I'm using 1 variable. Instead of using 2 operator, I'm using 1 operator. Okay. The code above, add the number entered by the user to the total variable with each loop iteration. Once the loop stops executed, the value of total is printed. The value in the sum is entered. Okay? So far, okay to you? Alright, so let's continue. Alright, so same thing here. We're going to enter 5 numbers, exactly what we did before. So that must be while, right? And the total, I want to notice that the initialization value, total has initialized to 0. Alright, so total equal total plus 5 number. Well, this line, can anybody tell me what's a shortcut way to do it? Anybody can tell me what's the shortcut way to do it?
A total plus equals number?
Yeah, this.
Semicolon.
Yeah, good job. All right, great. That's good. Total plus equal number. That's a better way to do it. Is that right? Because this one has two variables. Every time you call a variable, it's going to retrieve from the from your memory, right? So, and these two operator, I have only one operator. So that's much simplified already. All right, so we're going to continue. And let's go to next. All right, so there's a lot long way to go, sorry. And we're going to talk about something called for loop. For loop. And the for loop is also repetition loop condition. But what happened is for loop use different. Usually we use for loop is we know ahead of time how many times you want to do it. Now, the while loop we show you, they use number. Usually we don't use number for while loop. We use while loop when we need to check a condition. The condition usually is not number. For loop is you already know how many times we do like that. So integer, initialization value, condition increment. For these four, so I always tell students, all right, so if I want to do 10 times, okay, this one is 1 and less than 10, so this actually 9 times. This actually 9 times. The initial, it asks you first, then increment by 1, and this will be 9 times because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 is not less than 10, okay? So normally, for loop on 4, this is correct. All right, so this is 9 times. All right, so the example of for loop will be 0 to 9, like this way. Okay, 0 and less than 10. In the initial step, A to 0, A less than 10 is a condition, A plus plus, that's increment. All right, so we just ask you to try to do for loop, so you put 4 and this increment. All right, so it's possible to change increment? Yes. Now, for example, this one, A equals 0, A less than 50, A plus 10. All right, so for this one, the first value, you got it. The first A will be A equal, the first A is 0. All right, so who can tell me what's the next A? Because you are going to increment by 10, is that right? So what's next A? Isn't next A is 10?
Yeah.
Good. So can you tell me what's next A?
20?
Yeah. And it will continue 30, and it will stop at until A is what?
40.
That's right. Yes, that's right. Because it has to stop at 40 because, you know, once it's 50 now is less than 50. Do you understand? So it just lets you see these. You can increment it not only by 1. Can be by 10, by 2, by 5, by anything. Oh, you can subtract too. You understand? For example, this one, A equal 10. As long as A is greater than 0, each time is minus by 3. So the first time I'll put it here, A will be equal 10. So can anybody tell me what's next A? Anybody?
7?
Yeah, good. Thank you. Charlton, right? Great. Can anybody tell me what's next A?
Four.
Good job. Can anybody tell me what's next? A.
One.
Yeah. All right. We'll stop because after A equal 1, then if you A subtract by 3 is negative 2. Negative 2 is not greater than 0, so you will stop. Do you understand that? Okay, very important is don't put semicolon after for loop. Okay? Don't put semicolon after for loop. Alright. So, for we want to do these multiple by 2. So, 0 to 20. Okay? So, this will give you all the even number. Don't put semicolon here. Okay? So, you can increment by number, you can decrement by number. It was fun, okay? And let's continue here. We going to do the do while loop. When we do do while loop, in the class I will tell you, do while loop usually we call post while loop. We check after. But mainly it's because I have more than one condition want to check. I need to check more than one condition and I use do while loop. So unlike for and while loop, the do while loop is test at the bottom of the loop. Do while loop is similar to while loop, but while loop is you check the condition first. Then do while loop check the condition at the last. Alright? So do, then check the condition. And for us, we usually do while loop when we have more than one condition need to concern about it. So do while test. Okay. So this is same thing. A equals 0 and less than 5. So you will do what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So same thing. While 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Alright, so again, A equal 24. Okay. So I got 24. And now A is going to become 43. Is A less than 5? Yeah. No, it's 42, so you'll stop. Okay. So what happened is the do while, you see, it will ask you at least once. So I do 42 at least once, then check. And while loop, no. Sometimes you don't have output at all because you check first. All right, while first do while, okay. So do while. Run your code at least once. Do while loop. As with other loop, if the conditional loop never evaluate to false, a loop will run forever. So sometimes you get infinitive. Like this, integer A equal 42. If you don't update, it will be go infinity loop. To stop the infinity loop, you need to use control, okay? Control C to stop. Alright, so x equal 1, okay, and plus plus, while x less than 15. So you give a do number and the end you check right here. That's the last you check. Alright, then we are going to, we talk about switch already, is that right?